In this upcoming series, Stephen Curry will be facing LeBron James. They face each other a bunch of times in the finals. Steph has beat him 3 times to 1. And in the regulars, I think in all games, I think he's beaten him like 25 to 18. So Steph has gotten the best of LeBron James. A lot of people say LeBron James is the best player ever. Do you think he's even better than Steph?
I think Steph's a better player than he is. Look, I want to say a few things. I covered Stephen Curry, so I'm more familiar with what he does. I never covered LeBron James, but I've seen him play a lot. I don't particularly like his game. I mean, he's a guy, the offense has to go through him. He has to have his hands on it. He has to boss people around. And he's not a particularly, unless I'm wrong, he's not a particularly great outside shooter the way Curry is.
He's an average shooter. Yeah.
Yeah.
With no mid-range game. Really no mid-range game.
Yeah, he's a scorer, but he's not a shooter. Yeah. And I absolutely prefer Curry. And another way I would say it, you know, I try to think of, I'm a baby. You make all-star teams. My all-time starting five, point guard, I would say it's only one of two guys, Magic Johnson or Curry. And I would actually prefer Curry. They do different things. Probably not as great a passer as Magic Johnson, but way better scorer and as much of a team player. So I would say either one of those is my point guard. But on my top five, LeBron James doesn't make it. I look at him as maybe the shooting forward. Larry Bird. I would take Larry Bird over him in an eye blink.
Yeah, I think it's interesting. Like, if you're talking about that all-time starting five, Curry could fit, I think, in any team, any lineup, because you could play him at point guard if you needed to. Or if you have Magic Johnson, you could put him off the ball and have Magic passing to Curry. Like, he fits. But if LeBron's on that team, he has to have the ball in his hands. So if you have, you can't have Magic and LeBron on the same team. You can't. But you could have Magic and Curry on the same team.
I love it. I love that point. Yeah. In fact, LeBron James would be sort of a drag on that team.
Yes. I mean, if you had Jordan on the team, you'd have to run it through LeBron. Otherwise, what's LeBron doing? Shooting? Spot-up shooter? He's not particularly good.
No.
No. So, yeah, I think that's interesting.
Another thing is I have dealt with any number of superstars that I covered. I've covered superstars. Stephen Curry is the least superstarish of any superstar I covered. And here's what I mean. Again, I don't know him personally at all. I don't know what he's like in the house. I have no idea, so I can't speculate. I know how he presents to the media. And this is how he presents. Normal. Raymond Ritter, their head of public relations, you know, say, you know, in a series, I imagine on the off day, Steph is going to talk. In the gym over here in Oakland, they used to put him in a high chair. He would sit. We'd all gather around with our pads and our microphones. He would give us as much time as possible. He was always in a good mood. He never, ever, when I was there, said a shitty, bitchy thing to a writer. If he didn't like or didn't understand a question, he was polite, say, I don't agree or I don't understand, please say it again, the way a gentleman would do.
Yeah.
In addition, now I can't speak for LeBron James because I've never covered him. I don't know how he is. But I can tell you, as a superstar, the only other one who was like that was Steve Young. Steve Young has the same lovely, normal demeanor. And I think you could say Steve was a superstar as well. What are you going to say, Guy?
Well, there was another NBA player that I would say that might be better than LeBron James too that never really gets put in this discussion. But Tim Duncan.
Well, I mean, he's my number four. He's my four on my all-time team.
Tim Duncan won 5 championships.
Yeah.
Beat LeBron in the finals. You could argue he's the best big man of his era, better than Shaq. But he was so quiet. He wasn't a self-promoter that people talk about Shaq and Kobe as being better than him. But, I mean, I'll take Tim Duncan. Are you kidding?
On my starting five, he's the power forward on my starting five.
Absolutely.
I want to say another thing about Curry and LeBron James, which may or may not be germane to anything. Curry, when people talk about him, some people call him Steph, but for the most part, during a play-by-play, it's Curry gets the ball, Curry takes a three-pointer. Yeah. But with James, it's LeBron.
Right.
Like a title.
Like a brand.
And a brand and a title. So I feel the ego of the way people treat him or what he projects is so much different from Curry. Curry, it's not a brand. He's just he's a member of the team. And this guy, you got to call him King James, that kind of thing. And he pronounces, I mean, he doesn't only talk about basketball. He talks about politics. And, you know, sometimes I think things he says are maybe he shouldn't have said them. And I wish that he had less of an ego. For example, I told you it's very easy to get Stephen Curry. He's there every day and they bring him. Mm-hmm. You think it's like that in LA with LeBron James? You think he's sitting around it? You think he's sitting around and talking to the media every day and say, take as long as you want? I don't know, but I have a feeling it's not like that.
Probably not. I would think not. Again, he's a brand. He's a Nike athlete. They're Nike and the NBA are like synonymous, and they've been trying to market him as the next Jordan because Jordan was, I mean, he kept the league afloat in the 90s. He was the whole league. And then he retired, and I think they feel they need the next one to, because they're not the number one sport in America. The NFL is. So Jordan makes them relevant, but he's not the best player of his era. Curry is. Curry's won more championships. Curry's beaten him in the finals. Curry's won the same amount of championships, but he's beaten him in the finals three times. And he's going to do it again in this series. I'm predicting Warriors in seven.
I want to also tell you, you guys may have seen this on the internet, but in game six, Jordan Poole did something wrong.
Yeah.
And he was discouraged. It was a timeout, and he was walking off the court. And LeBron James touched him and clearly wanted to cheer him up. Mm-hmm. And he pushed LeBron James away. Did you see it, Iggy?
Was it LeBron or was it Draymond?
What am I saying?
I think it was Draymond.
Yeah. It was Draymond. I'm sorry.
I saw that.
I'm an old man.
It's okay.
Coming off the court, Draymond Green tries to say something nice, you know, to encourage him, and he pushes Draymond Green away.
Yep.
Curry walks right. And then Poole sits down. Curry walks right over to him, and he says, "That's not fucking helpful," and walks away. So, you know, that's quiet leadership. You don't do that. That's not fucking helpful. He either said that or that doesn't fucking help, but he used fucking, and it was either help or helpful. And it's all over the internet, Iggy. Wow. And so here's what's interesting. This Poole guy, who I've never met, he got punched by LeBron James. I'm sorry.
By Draymond. Got you.
Draymond, which was a bad look, clearly, for Draymond. But clearly, Draymond Green wasn't happy with him. And now the superstar is not happy with him. Those are two very negative votes from two kind of very important players.
Yeah, dude. So he better play a lot better the rest of this playoffs, or else I don't know if he's going to be on this team next year.
Yeah, he pushed Draymond Green away.
Imagine having like arguably the greatest player of all time come up to you during a game and saying you're not fucking helping. Like, I would just retire.
It's not fucking helpful. What? That doesn't fucking help. Yeah.
Jesus. Apparently, they had like a private players-only meeting before Game 7, and Steph like talked, and he doesn't normally do that. And apparently his message was, you know, I need you guys to put aside your like petty emotional stuff. Get it, like, stop being emotional, and you need to buy in and trust me. And if you trust me, I will deliver this win in Game 7. If you can't do that, don't get on the bus. Everyone felt he was talking about Poole. Like, hey man, like, what are you in this for? Do you want to win, or do you want to make this about you? Like, we can go up to Sacramento and win if you trust me, but it's not about you, dude.
I love it. And I love that. And I love what Stephen Curry did.
On the bus.
But it also seems to imply that Poole and Green have not made up.
I don't think so.
I mean,
a guy punches you in the face. It's hard to make up after that. But I mean, when it happened, everyone said, well, Draymond's an asshole. It was a sucker punch. Now it's like, well, what did Poole say to him? Because now it seems like he might be the kind of guy who is sort of asking for it. I mean, you pushed Draymond aside like during a game. So he could go sit by himself and pout. Whoa, dude. Well, there's a lot at stake here. You're not going to be the reason we freaking lose, dude. So you might, I mean,
so
Jordan punched Steve Kerr. Remember that?
Yes.
He did.
Yep. So, yep. Iggy, you follow the NBA more than I do. Pick a winner, Lakers and Warriors.
I think the Warriors are going to win in six or seven. I'll say seven. I think the reason the Kings gave the Warriors so much problems because they were young and could run, and the Warriors had looked really old and tired. I mean, LeBron's like 38 years old. I don't think there's going to be very much running going on in the series. The issue, I think, is rebounding. Warriors had a tough time rebounding against Sacramento in the first round, and the Lakers are even bigger. Like, Anthony Davis is huge. LeBron's a good rebounder, and if Kevon Looney isn't, how good is Kevon Looney all of a sudden? If he isn't getting 15 rebounds a game, the Warriors are in trouble. But all of a sudden, it looks like he's taking his game to a whole different level, playing 30 minutes a game. Who the hell is Kevon Looney? It's great.
I know. And Iggy, yeah. How many offensive rebounds keeping plays alive? It's wonderful.
Let me ask you this. Who was the Warriors' second best player in that series against the Kings?
Him. Looney.
Unreal. Absolutely. They would not have won that series without Looney playing as well as he did.
I agree.
That was amazing.
I agree. Really and, cool. You know, it's interesting. He's not a scoring center, but he doesn't have to be.
Nope.
He doesn't have to be.
It was amazing. Like, his whole career, he's been a guy who plays maybe 20 minutes a game. Now he's playing 30 minutes a game and giving him 15 rebounds. Like, whoa, that's great. If he keeps doing that, they'll go far.
He was better than Sabonis.
He was better than Draymond. He was better than Clay. He was just phenomenal.
Yeah.
Wonder if he can keep it going.
Iggy, on the Lakers, aside from James and Anthony Davis, who's a good player?
They have some guys that I don't know that well, but they're actually having a good year. They're kind of no-name players. Austin Reeves starts for them. He's pretty good. They have a guy named Rui Hachimura off the bench who's good. Like, they actually added a bunch of vet no-name bench players at the trade deadline, and the Warriors didn't. So that could be a factor here, too. I think the Lakers are a little deeper than the Warriors.
The Warriors are not deep.
No.
They're not deep. And that's an issue. They're not deep. Iggy, when you went to UCLA, did you ever go to Lakers games?
No, I went to UCLA games. They're a lot of fun there on campus. Pauley Pavilion is the best place to watch a basketball game. Pauley.
Right, and it's UCLA. Yeah. I got it. Why would you schlep over there? Yeah.
Yeah, it's the other side of town. And as you saw, people don't realize about LA. Like, it seems kind of small and things are 10 miles away, and then you get in a car and it's an hour. It's like, what happened? How did it take this long? Yeah, that's every day.